This video memoir is an overview of the depth and breadth of my life creating and making.
This scene has been carved into the surface of a solid piece of wood. This is an example of deep relief carving. The rails of the fence were first carved, and then the stones of the barn foundation were carved behind the rails. Thank you. Time and water had destroyed the fine original details of the ceiling of the governor's ceremonial office in the Vermont State House. Drawings were done from old photographs of the details that had once adorned the ceiling. Rick Schneider carved prototypes from these drawings. Molds were made from his carvings, and multiples were cast in plaster. These were laid like tiles to recreate the original ceiling details. The finished medallions are 45 inches in diameter and stand 8 inches down from the ceiling at their centers. There are 5 of these ceiling medallions on the governor's chamber ceiling in the Vermont State House. Schneider carved this acorn and oak leaf prototype in mahogany for restoring the plasterwork of the governor's chamber ceiling in the Vermont State House. Plaster acorn and oak leaf vines encircle the governor's chamber ceiling where it meets the walls. This open latticework sits across the mouth of a 7-inch cove. The oak vine pattern is carved so that when multiple plaster castings are placed end to end, the vines and leaves become continuous and flowing. Thank you. This is some of Rick's work as described by Architectural Digest in November 1997. Animating the entrance gallery is the oak and maple spiral stair, which, like the side table slash bridge miniature, was designed and fabricated by Schneider. The sinew of the house's interior is epitomized by the helical stairway that dominates the entrance. In one curling twist, widening from a 3-foot base to 6.5 feet at the top, it extends upward from the first floor to the bridge level. As it articulates the spacious entrance, the oak and maple stair offers the first view of the creek running under the house.
These staircases are known all over North America, and they're in the form of helixes. Welcome to Bristol, Vermont. I want you to picture a spring, a coiled spring, like a slinky. And I want you to picture pulling it apart. You know the spiral that the spring makes? That's called a helix. That's a geometric form. And I'm sitting here under a staircase that's built like one. It's like a giant coiled spring. See that pile of wood right there? That's where it starts. The man who turns that pile of wood into this piece of sculpture, because that's what it is not just a carpenter, he really is an artist. His name is Rick Schneider, and that's where we are, in Rick's workshop.
Hi, welcome.
Thanks for having us. I mean, this is spectacular. Is it bent wood?
It's not bent, it's stacked layers of wood. In this case, there are 5 layers of wood. And I've glued up a stack of these 5 layers, and then I've used a template to describe an arc or some fancy
spindle. How many hours for a 2-story staircase or 3? I mean, give me an idea of how long this takes to put this staircase together.
This is a 2-story staircase. Each flight is 11 feet, and it's probably about 2,000 hours, which is one man 50, 40-hour week, so a year's labor.
For one staircase?
For one double flight staircase, yes.
That's incredible. A year's work on one staircase for one house. You've got to really love what you do.
I do. No question about it.
And it shows. Okay.
So initially I went back to my physics and got out all the calculus books and tried to do this with formulas. But I put them away and did it point to point, used practical common sense. So I really think anybody could do this if they just use their heads and draw it in two dimensions and then think of projecting it vertically.
I don't think anybody else could do this, Rick. Brilliant and talented. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This has been a real pleasure.
Thank you.
This is gorgeous.
This leg was carved out of basswood as a prototype for a cast lamp base. Molds made from this carving were used to cast multiple legs for a production line of floor lamp bases. Thank you.
It is here that Rick's hands and imagination construct staircases. He also builds furniture that is inspired by both man and nature.
Doing something uniquely creative is both satisfying and stimulating for me.
Today, Rick is constructing one of his signature helix staircases, like the one in his studio.
Staircases add a strong element of gracefulness to a home. They're very nice curves.
Rick Schneider beats a path through the woods of Moncton, Vermont, straight to his studio, where he's ready to begin the next step in making his curving staircase. It's at the lathe where work becomes fun for Rick.
One of the most fun things is turning on the lathe, because I really like seeing that shape evolve. Most of woodworking has to do with setting up machines to a precise predetermined dimension and then just passing something through it. The lathe is totally the opposite, starting with something and using a hand tool to shape graceful curves. That's very satisfying for me.
The sharp blade of the chisel seems to melt away the wood, leaving behind softly rounded decorative beams.
I know in my staircase work, it's distinguished by the design. So it's taking these horizontal lines and turning them into this vertical, graceful shape that is a big challenge.
Building this winding staircase takes vision, time, and a great deal of effort. But nature builds this kind of curving form effortlessly.
I think that a spiral is one of those things that has a natural beauty, and we find it throughout nature. We find it in seashells. We find it in the DNA molecule, this same helix. It's one of nature's primary beautiful structures.
Rick Schneider's spiral staircase not only takes those who tread its stairs from floor to floor, but also on a journey of imaginative design.
Made from these two carved urethane foam prototypes. The molds were then used to make multiple cast aluminum fish. A whole school of aluminum fish were then set flush in a concrete walkway that leads to a trout pond. This seated Japanese Buddha was sculpted from Douglas fir. 19 5-inch by 7-inch columns of wood were glued vertically to make a 260-pound block from which Rick sculpted this Buddha. The finished Buddha was life-size and weighed 150 pounds. Schneider is working on a collection of artwork entitled Femme Florale. Each piece is a sculpture combining the natural beauty of flowers with that of the human form. Rick has begun the Femme Florale collection with the Iris series, a progression of carved irises with a sculpted female unfolding within the blossoms. In the beginning of the series, the flower is closed and the woman is tightly folded in child's position. She then awakens, begins emerging, and by the end of the series, the woman is standing and the blossom has opened. In these sculptures, Schneider has combined black cherry and black walnut woods to create naturally sensual artwork. The sculptures are supported by Champlain black marble bases, quarried on Isle Lamont, an island in northern Lake Champlain, Vermont. This black marble was formed from sediments deposited approximately 450 million years ago. The Iris series crescendos as it develops. The sculptures get progressively larger. The flower and the woman unfold and open. The woman ages gracefully as the four-part sequence develops. Iris budding beauty, iris awakening, iris emerging, and iris full bloom. This Iris series is also available in cast bronze. In bronze, envision the sculptures placed in an outdoor setting, where they are encountered sequentially as along a path or in a garden setting. In Femme Florale, Rick Schneider is combining his woodworking and sculptural skills and experiences from over 30 years. Graceful shapes and the beauty of natural forms have inspired Rick throughout his career. These influences are focused in Femme Florale as the fusion